Hello everyone. Today we're going to talk about an important topic in natural dyeing, and that is color fastness. So color fastness is how long your fiber is going to hold on to that natural dye over time with exposure to light and water. Because how your naturally dyed fiber looks the day you dye it is not necessarily how it is going to look within a few months or a few years. Now, some dyes hold on to their color really well, and that's called excellent color fastness, such as indigo, madder, those are the common ones. But others lose their color quite quickly, which is called poor light fastness, like black beans, beets, turmeric. So I'm gonna show you a quick and easy test that you can do to test your own experiments for color fastness when it comes to light exposure. Now, I will use both great color fast dyes and not so great color fast dyes, but I want to know which is which before I use it in a project. And I'm a knitter, so I put a lot of time into these shawls and sweaters that I knit. So for example, one of my favorite dye flowers is black hollyhock, and I've achieved fantastic blues, but the only true blue really comes from indigo. So I knew that going into the shawl I was going to knit, which meant I wasn't disappointed when it did start to fade to gray. And I'll show you what I mean. So when I first knit this shawl, this color down here was a very bright blue, similar to this here. This is indigo. Now I knew this wasn't gonna stay this blue. It was gonna fade out into a gray. So I just paired it with something that would have high contrast, like a very easy undyed white and a different natural dye that does have good light fastness. One of my favorites, onion skins. Because I knew it going into the project, I wasn't disappointed. And that is really important, especially for someone who's just starting out. So let's get to that color fast test. So this is a very simple test. I did not invent it. You could probably find it in most dye books, but I use it all the time. All you need are some note cards, or a piece of cardboard would work great. I use two basic note cards and some scissors, pen, and tape. Regular Scotch tape would probably work, but I actually kind of like the packing tape. So I'm going to take a sample from two skeins that I have here. Let's use indigo. So I have oak gall dyed yarn and I have some indigo. And I'm gonna undo the skein and I'm gonna snip off one of the little ties that we used that you would otherwise throw away, like so. This is why it's handy to have several ties so that you can still keep your skein neat even if you snip off one. And then this is my indigo dyed wool. And I will snip off this one. You're gonna snip off a little sample of yarn and then you're gonna tape it inside your note cards. So you have your two samples. You have your note card and you are going to tape half of it in like this so that at least half of it is hanging out. And also write down what the dye is, especially if you're doing more than one so that you'll remember. So let's see if I can find my tape. Start. Oh, there it is. Okay. Because this is so long, I'm gonna double it up. So half is going to go in side my note card, and I'm gonna tape it so it's nice and snug. I'm gonna do the same thing with my oak gall. Taping securely, so half is in, half is out. And then write what is what. Even though it's this situation, it's pretty obvious, but sometimes it might not be. And you'll also want to include the date that you started this test. Now you're simply going to fold it in half so that you have half of your yarn hanging out the side and the other half that's taped is snugly inside. That way this half can be exposed to light, whereas this half is not. You'll want to tape this up into a window that doesn't get direct sunlight all day. Unless, let's say you're doing like a wall hanging where it is going to get direct sunlight and you want to know how that direct sunlight will affect your yarn, then you might want to do it that way. But generally, I hang it up in a window that's not going to get direct sunlight. I tape it securely and I leave it there for 2 weeks, 3 weeks. If I forget it, you know, I come back later. And then I check to see how the color changed from this side versus this side. Now let me also show you a test that I started several weeks ago. This is using pokeberry and carrot tops. Here I have pokeberry and pokeberry aftermath, and then carrot tops, those green leafy bits at the top of a carrot. Now pokeberries are notorious for not having great light fastness. So I am not that surprised when I compare the strands that were exposed to the sun versus the ones that were not, that there is some light fading even after a few weeks. The same with the pokeberry afterbath, although it's a little tricky to see. There is some light fading between what was hidden and what was exposed to the light. However, with these carrot tops, I can see when I compare the two sides, that there really isn't any difference at all, which makes me believe that this carrot top is going to have much better light fastness than the pokeberry. Now, if you want to test how your fiber is going to hold up to water, then you would take a sample and you would wash it as you expect to wash it, either by hand or in the washing machine. Do it a few times and then compare that sample to the original. So these tests really help me when I'm planning out how I'm going to use my fiber in my future knitting project, and I hope they'll be able to help you do the same.